One of the most important areas of Excel use is the use of dates, and more importantly, making use of valid dates that Excel recognizes. So just to explain that concept, here we have a whole number of dates. Each of these in different places or to different people represent a valid Excel date. But how do we know which one Excel actually sees as a valid date? The important thing to realize is that dates in Excel are actually numbers based on the 1st of January 1900. A way to see if Excel actually sees a date as a proper date is what you can do is you go to your formatting, and if we go to general, when I say OK, anything that's a valid date will actually change to a number. Anything that doesn't change is Excel not recognizing as a date. Another way is if I change it to a date format, for example, I'm going to put it so that you see the full name of the calendar of the month. Notice that only one of them changed. So at the moment, this is the only cell that actually has a valid date in it. Just going to undo. Another way to check is to just add one to the date. So I'm going to go here and say that plus one. And you'll notice that only the cells that seem to have a valid date in it actually do something with the number. You will have noticed that this one here also acted as a date, but this is a separate issue that is dealt with elsewhere. Another way to test for a valid date is to make use of the isNumber formula in Excel. So you'll see we've got it here, isNumber. And all this says is point at a cell, and it'll tell you whether it is a number or not. You'll see there it says false, and when I copy it down, notice that it says false for anything that Excel doesn't see as a number, and true for what it does see as a number. And keeping in mind that in Excel, a date is merely a number from the 1st of January 1900. This will give you a good indication of what dates Excel sees as dates and which it doesn't.